Hi, my name is Kevin, and I'm a support engineer at Preemptive. Today I want to show you a demo of Dotfuscator, our .NET protection product, and how to protect a Xamarin application using Dotfuscator inside Visual Studio. I'm going to start off by showing you how easy it is for anyone to reverse engineer a .NET application. Then I'll show you how easy it is to protect your application from an attack using Dotfuscator. I'm going to demonstrate Dotfuscator today with an application called Bug Sweeper. It's a simple application that acts like the game Minesweeper. As you can see, it's a working application. Okay, now let's see how easy it is to crack the application open and look at the source code. I'm going to use a common reverse engineering tool called ILSpy, an open source decompiler available on GitHub. It's that easy to get something to reverse engineer an application. All I need to do is select the assemblies I want to reverse engineer, and they'll appear here in the tree. I select what I want to look at, and the code shows up here in the viewer. I can easily view the source code of this application. So now I'll show you how easy it is to protect your application using Dotfuscator. I'll go back to Visual Studio and unload the project, and then edit the project file. At the end of the file, I'm going to copy and paste this code that's available in our documentation under the Protect Your App section. The code tells Dotfuscator what configurations we want to run the obfuscation on. It also tells Dotfuscator to generate a configuration file if it doesn't already exist. Next, I'm going to reload the project. Now I can navigate to my project folder and see that the Dotfuscator configuration file was created. I'm going to open that file in Dotfuscator. I can see that it pulled in all the assemblies included in my project. The main setting on this input tab is library mode. When library mode is enabled, it will exclude all public and protected members from renaming. If appropriate, turning library mode off will allow Dotfuscator to rename much more and provide much more protection. Next, let's review some high-level settings. As you can see, there are quite a few settings that we can apply to our project. To keep this simple, I'm going to focus on just a few things. The first thing I want to show you is that you can turn on or off each of our obfuscation features globally. You can see here that the defaults are to have control flow and renaming turned on, and everything else turned off. As you can see, each obfuscation transform has a corresponding tab. So let's take a look at control flow. Control flow works by altering code patterns that decompilers use to recreate source code. Dotfuscator introduces false conditional statements and other misleading constructs in order to confuse and break decompilers. This process synthesizes branching, conditional and iterative constructs that produce valid forward executable logic but yields non-deterministic semantic results when decompilation is attempted. In addition to adding code constructs, Dotfuscator works by destroying the code patterns that decompilers use to recreate source code. The end result is code that is semantically equivalent to the original but contains no clues as to how the code was originally written. Dotfuscator also provides the option to exclude specific methods from control flow. There are quite a few more detailed options for control flow and other obfuscation transforms, but I won't get into that now. Now let's save the config file and go back to Visual Studio and rebuild our project. I'll try to open the obfuscated assemblies created by Dotfuscator. Now when I try to look at the code, you can see that the code that showed up here last time has been obfuscated and is no longer available for me to read. So that was a very quick overview of Dotfuscator on a Xamarin application. Remember, we offer free evaluations for you to test Dotfuscator on your own project. We're available to extend evaluations if you need more time, and offer support to you during the evaluation period if you have any technical issues. If you would like further information, please email us at solutions@preemptive.com. Thank you for watching.